In this video, we take a look at the top 5 features coming your way in SAP Analytics Cloud. These include AI-assisted advanced formula generation, AI-assisted chart summary in Microsoft PowerPoint, AI-assisted commenting, new homepage, and new table experience. Hi, my name is Orla Cullen, and these are your What's New updates for QRC3 2025. In this release, we have some exciting new AI features coming your way. Let's start with AI-assisted advanced formula generation. With this enhancement, we allow users to use AI to generate documentation from script and to generate advanced formula scripts from business comments. Here we have an advanced formula, and when we highlight the script, we generate documentation using textual descriptions. We can also generate an advanced formula script by simply entering a business comment and have AI generate the script. I can then accept or reject the generated content and refine further as needed. Next up, we have the new AI-assisted chart summary, which leverages generative AI to automatically generate concise summaries of SAP Analytics Cloud charts embedded in your PowerPoint presentations. Let's take a closer look. I want to get some information on how my sales is trending, so I select a sales forecast chart, including last year's actuals. I preview the widget and then add this to my PowerPoint presentation. This chart has a lot of information, which may be difficult to summarize. So I can now click on the new Generate Summary button, and the chart information is sent to the Just Ask Generative AI Hub, which generates a 3-bullet summary. I can now see which products are performing well and which ones are not, and see the global performance trends across all categories. I can also edit the comments by making use of all the text features available in PowerPoint. So I can generate an initial version of a chart summary, which I can easily modify as necessary. All the charts, as well as the summaries, can be refreshed at any time to reflect any changes in the underlying data. Staying with AI, we now take a look at AI-assisted commenting, which enables users to leverage generative AI to summarize data point comments via the table and comment widget to provide better decision support to our end users. In this scenario, we are looking at travel expenses, where we see a large variance in our dashboard. We open another story to dive deeper into the details. As my user language profile is set to Spanish, we see the long comment summarized in Spanish, which makes the comment easier for me to understand. We will switch the language profile back to English and regenerate the summary. As many of our customers are multinational, we know our customers will appreciate this capability. We can also summarize common threads. This is especially important where multiple stakeholders are providing their insights. Next, we use AI-assisted commenting to summarize comments along the hierarchy, which in this case is the United States and Germany. If comments were entered in other languages, they will be summarized and translated to the user's profile language. For the user that needs to author comments, we provide the ability to rephrase the comment with a simple click of a button. Rephrasing comments can often improve the quality and clarity of a comment for other reviewers. We have added a new comment that we will be reducing non-customer related travel next quarter, and we can then regenerate the AI comment summary with the All Cost Centers node. Let's take a closer look at our commenting widget, which would normally be integrated into our dashboard. First widget shows the USA cost center, where we will summarize the thread, and the second widget shows the German cost center, where we will summarize the long comment, which is over 500 characters. With AI-assisted commentary, working with comments just got a whole lot easier. The next exciting feature we have for you this quarter is the new home screen experience. You will straight away notice a change to our overall look and feel, and we've also added new features and more customization options. So let's dive in and see it in action. 5 new cards are being introduced to the home screen. First, we take a look at the onboarding card, which provides a brand new onboarding experience, which includes links to helpful tours and learning courses, so you can get up to speed with the product in no time. It also comes with a search bar where you can type any question you may have, which will lead you to the appropriate help documentation. Next up is the Quick Actions card, which allows you to choose 4 quick actions from a broad selection and add them directly to your home screen. From the menu, you can click Edit Quick Actions, and then you can select the quick actions you want and then click OK. In this example, if I regularly create new stories, I can add the Create Canvas action, which brings me directly to a new story and a blank canvas. Back at the home screen, we also see that Just Ask now comes as a card containing advanced search bar powered by generative AI. It enables users to initiate a search directly from the home screen using natural language. Not only does it let you enter your search, but also lets you refine it by selecting your data and adding attributes that Just Ask then opens and pre-populates your search from the card with the result. For example, if I want to see sales by product category, it would redirect to Just Ask screen where I can further drill down into the result and select even more dimensions and even edit my query. To help you explore our community, see upcoming updates, and learn more about making the most of your SAP solutions, we have created the Resource Card. This card provides quick and easy access to various types of information about the product. You can find everything from a simple story to business content, release updates, and more. For example, if I want to see the Roadmap Explorer for SAP Analytics Cloud, I simply click and then I will be redirected directly to the Roadmap Explorer. The final card that I would like to introduce is the Favorite card. This lists your favorite files and allows you to filter them. For example, if I would only like to see my favorites folder, I can simply apply that filter to the card. Aside from our cards, we have revamped some of our existing cards, such as calendar highlights, the recent files, feature files, and the data change insight card. All cards now come with search options and improved filtering experience. Next, let's explore the customization possibilities provided within your new experience. All of our cards can be repositioned and the card layout is responsive. For further customization, you can select the Customize button on the top right-hand corner of your home screen, and here you can decide which cards to display and which cards to hide. Last, but by no means least, this quarter we bring you the new table experience, which provides interface consistency with chart widgets and includes all the features of classic tables. This incorporates a number of new features, but today we will take a closer look at the blending for a table with support of sort and rank. We start by adding a new table into the story and giving it a correct size. Then we add a linked model. Users have the ability to edit the linked model to modify or to better understand the dimensions used. We can also change the link type to let the table return intersecting data only. Now we can start to add dimensions and measures. Linked dimensions must be used and can be a measure, dimension, or a filter. Here we add a linked dimension from our primary model and at least 4 measures, 2 from our primary model and 2 from the linked model. Now we can see our data loaded into our blended table. From here, we can now create a blended calculation and a threshold on the blended calculation. We can also apply client calculations such as cumulative sum. Let's dive into sorting. This is a blended table with version dimension. We select one data cell and open the value sorting dialog box from the contextual menu. We can now change the sorting sequence. We can restrict the sorting on one specific version member and apply. Sort token is then added to the table subtitle, and the user can use it to open or delete existing settings. If we do it again by toggling off the restricted sorting on version, it will apply the sort on each version member. Now let's move on to restricted sorting on rows or columns. It applies to cross table when dimensions exist in both rows and columns. In this first example, the sort is applied by column on the account income for the dimension color and its member blue. If we repeat the same workflow, we can now apply a sort by rows on precisely which dimensions to use. For the second example, it will be the dimension category actual and the location North America. Let's take a look at rank in a blended table. If we select one data cell and open the rank dialog box from the contextual menu, we can apply rank on dimension with 3 new different options: all dimensions individually, or each dimension separately. In this demo, we'll apply a top 2 on all dimensions individually. Thank you for joining us to learn about some of the top features coming your way in Q3 2025 release cycle of SAP Analytics Cloud. Check out the video description for more links to resources about this quarter's updates. And remember to leave a like on this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date with all things SAP Analytics Cloud. Thanks again, I'll see you next time.